Thank you very much, Mr. Ismail. Yeah. Let me thank the IMF and for hosting this press conference. I'll be very brief because my colleague here has said a lot of things which I think refer also to part of our region. I'll concentrate on what has been happening at the IMF within the last 5 days. The stability of the global economy has been the main focus of the 2011 annual meetings this week. The assessment of the global economic outlook has been well captured by the statements of the heads of the IMF and World Bank, having entered a danger zone. There's a growing consensus that the majority of our trading and development partners, the advanced economies, will most likely experience a second round of severe economic downtime. Our economies are interconnected as never before in many aspects, from trading to financial flows. In that regard, the risks to the African economies, and especially the East African economies, are considerable. The East African region, consisting of the core 5 countries, that is Tanzania, Kenya, Uganda, Rwanda, and Burundi, and the immediate neighbors, the Democratic Republic of Congo, my neighbor here, South and Northern Sudan, Zambia, Mozambique, and Ethiopia, and to a great extent, our partners in the Southern Development Community, we constitute a dynamic economic zone, both in terms of growth and trade prospects. Over the years, we've strengthened our regional interconnectedness in parallel to our greater integration into the global economy. 3 years ago, we were all hit hard by especially the global economic downturn as the demand for our exports shrank and financial flows declined. We did manage to coordinate among our regional partners, our individual country and collective response to the economic downturn. As a result, we succeeded in shielding our banking system from the global financial crisis, but also helped our non-exposure policy to the then toxic assets. Our collective and bilateral response also helped to shield our economies from the deeper downturns. Our strong policy frameworks were supported by sizable fiscal and foreign reserves buffers. As a result, our counter-cyclical policy responses helped to swiftly revise the trend. Members of the press, let me mention that despite the strength of our policy frameworks and economic buffers that we had as we entered into the last global economic crisis and the swift recovery from that crisis, our economies are yet to attain the pre-crisis growth level as we now enter the second round and possibly the most challenging global economic crisis ever. As I mentioned earlier, the risks we face are more elevated than those we faced during the previous global economic crisis, and these risks will become more elevated if the global economy falters significantly. A problem that I can mention here, the global fuel and food price surge has protracted and at much higher levels than before the crisis. The economic shocks that will emanate from the euro area crisis and other advanced economies are expected to be stronger and possibly more severe than the last crisis. The climate change effects, especially the severe drought in Eastern Africa, is compounding the regional food supply deficit and price developments. Our economies are still in the recovery path and in the process of restoring the critical economic buffers. There's a real danger that the modest progress we have attended in meeting some of the MDGs will be eroded by ensuing global economic crisis. In line with the main theme of this year's annual meetings, we in Tanzania and the regional partners remain determined to respond with appropriate counter-cyclical measures in as much as our macroeconomic frameworks allow. We also remain determined to strengthen our policy and regulatory frameworks further to help shield our financial institutions and the key economic sectors from deeper downturns. In the spirit of the call by the IMF Managing Director and the President of our bank, We remain committed to work with global leaders to address the challenges we face. Regarding the Tanzania economic situation, I must say that our economic situation is quite good. It was better before the economic crisis. The growth rate before the economic crisis was 7% on average for successive years. Currently, it stands at 6.7%, but most of the indicators show that within the next 12 months, we might reach 7%, and after that, we shall start recovering and probably might reach the pre-economic crisis level of 7.4%. Macroeconomic stability is quite good, with a few areas here and there. And the problem that I may say, Tanzania needs the world to know. When we have a big crisis, like my colleague from DRC has said, we have an energy crisis. This is a really, really big crisis. We have power shortage in Tanzania. We believe that if the international community can come across and invest in Tanzania, in the power sector, we might reverse the situation, because energy is the mother of economic growth. Without energy, nothing can be done. We invite the international community, and through here, the press, we would wish that you educate the world to come and invest in Tanzania. We are opening up the energy sector. We are going to liberalize the energy sector, so that instead of the government alone investing in the energy sector, the private sector will be allowed to invest in the energy sector, so anybody who is interested in the energy sector is allowed. Tanzania is surrounded by six countries, including DRC. So improving the energy sector in Tanzania means improving the energy sector in the whole region. Mr. Chairman, I don't think I have more. I'll probably answer more questions when the floor is open. Let me rest there, saying that the economic situation in Tanzania is not as bad as one would have expected. We have some problems. The IMF secretary knows, but they are not insurmountable problems. They are problems that they are within our ability to control. Thank you very much.